Hey guys, I got disconnected. We're gonna try this one more time. So wanted to take just a couple of minutes on this beautiful Wednesday. Beautiful spring is coming, can you feel it? And talk about an idea that crosses both over in the world of team leadership and well in self-leadership, which you know I like to focus on. And I like to call this idea the three Jedis that you should either find or become. And it's basically a way to look at the skill sets that are becoming more and more prevalent and required to be successful in the modern world we live in, which is constantly a changing, constantly evolving, fast moving, nonstop. So the first Jedi you're going to want to find is one that the person that has mastered the skill or developed the skill to better than others navigate the future. And by this, I don't mean anything magical or mystical. I just mean that some people have hone the ability to look at where things are, see and understand with a better degree of clarity than others how things are developing, which way they're headed, and know where things are most probable to be in the future. Those people have the skill to navigate the future, right? So you need that person, visionary. The second Jedi you want to look for is one that has honed the ability to constantly take action now, maximizing now, leveraging now, never stopping now, never stop taking action, constantly moving, constantly changing, constantly moving. There are some people that just fits their personality. They are very good at it. And you need to have that type of skill set in your organization, or you need to develop that type of skill set and or mindset, right? And if you can have that Jedi of now take his direction from the Jedi that can navigate the future, you're off the road, you're down the way to developing a very powerful combination. Third Jedi you want to look for is the person that can navigate the past. By navigate the past, I don't mean navigate through different places. What I mean is they can navigate the meaning of the past. You need somebody with the ability to go back through history, your history, your organizational's history, history period, and see how those things, experiences, relationships, all the things that happened in the past are now relevant, not to now, but relevant to what is seen by the person that can navigate the future. So now you have the potential for a very powerful combination of things. If you can have the person that can navigate the past team up with the person that can navigate the future, come up with a single navigation plan where everything makes sense, and then give that direction to the person that never stops taking action, never stops changing, evolving, you are on your way to a powerful, powerful machine or a powerful personal skill set group. So which is the most powerful in the scenario? I'm going to argue that given this scenario, the most powerful person would be what I'm calling the fourth perspective, right? It's either the type of person that can step back and say and decide and commit to creating these type of skill sets in themselves, or the fourth person that can sit back and say that they are going to commit to finding these three different type of people that have the skill sets that they don't have. That's the most powerful person in this scenario. So something to think about as we make it halfway through the week. Hopefully it gives you a springboard to even bigger and better and greater thoughts of your own, but ones that you can apply today in the action that you are taking in your life right now. Three Jedis that you should find or become. Think about it. Have a great week.